We got to take a look at what I was left when I became president, what Mr. Trump left me. We had an economy that was in free fall. The pandemic was so badly handled. Many people were dying. All he said was, it's not that serious. Just inject a little bleach into your arm. You'll be all right. The economy collapsed.
We got hit with COVID. And when we did, we spent the money necessary so we wouldn't end up in a Great Depression, the likes of which we had in 1929. By the time we finished, so we did a great job. We got a lot of credit for the economy, a lot of credit for the military, and no wars, and so many other things. Everything was rocking good. As far as Afghanistan is concerned, I was getting out of Afghanistan, but we were getting out with dignity, with strength, with power. He got out. It was the most embarrassing day in the history of our country's life. The Supreme Court just approved the abortion pill, and I agree with their decision to have done that, and I will not block it. But I believe in the exceptions for rape, incest, and the life of the mother. I think it's very important.
The idea that the politicians, that the founders wanted the politicians to be the ones making decisions about women's health is ridiculous. And if I'm elected, I'm going to restore Roe v. Wade. He encouraged those folks to go up on Capitol Hill, number one. I sat in the dining room off the Oval Office. He sat there for 3 hours, watching, begging, being begged by his vice president and a number of his colleagues on the Republican side as well to do something, to call for a stop, to end it. Instead, he talked about these people being patriots and great patrons of America. In fact, he says he'll now forgive them for what they've done. The only person on this stage is a convicted felon is the man I'm looking at right now. The idea that you have a right to seek retribution against any American just because you're president is wrong. It's simply wrong. No president's ever spoken like that before. Having sex with a porn star on the night while your wife was pregnant, I mean, what are you talking about? You have the morals of an alley cat.
Give me a minute, sir.
I didn't have sex with a porn star, number one. Well, I took two tests, cognitive tests. I aced them, both of them, as you know. We made it public. He took none. I'd like to see him take one, just one, a real easy one. Like, go through the first five questions. He couldn't do it.
Will you accept the results of the election, regardless of who wins, yes or no, please?
If it's a fair and legal and good election, absolutely.
I doubt whether you'll accept it because you're such a whiner. The idea, if you lose again, you accepting anything, you can't stand the loss. Something snapped in you when you lost the last time.
He is the worst president. He just said about me because I said it. But look, he's the worst president in the history of our country. He's destroyed our country.
Presidential historians, they've had meetings and they voted who's the worst president in American history, one through best to worst. They said he was the worst in all of American history. That's a fact.